हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ फोर्थ क्लास, आई विशिंग टू ऑल ऑफ़ यू अ वेरी हैप्पी हेल्दी एंड प्लेजर डे। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर वेरी वेल विद ब्लेसिंग ऑफ ऑल माइटी गॉड। डियर स्टूडेंट, आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट यू रीडिंग ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 9। ओपन योर बुक ऑन पेज नंबर 52। वी विल डू द रीडिंग ऑफ 9th चैप्टर, हाउसेस चेंजिंग टाइम। A lot of things are used to build a house. Look at the picture and name as many things you can that are used in building a house. Right here, name of things which are used to made beautiful house. You can write here bricks. Sand and cement. These things are used to make beautiful house. Okay, students, you can write here bricks, cement and sand. We have learnt in previous class that house protect us from heat, cold, rain and wild animals. It is place where we keep ourselves safe and comfortable. Do you know what kind of house your grandparents live in when they were young? Rashmi is answering to the teacher, ma'am, once my grandmother told me that when she was young, the houses were quite different. Most people at that time lived in villages and built kaccha houses. These houses used to be built using simple material like mud, stone, bamboo, straw and leaves. The floors were usually made of clay and coated with kodak. Village people could get materials like mud, straw, leaves from their surroundings without paying much. Forest products like bamboo and wood were also easily available there. Today, many people still live in houses made of mud, clay and wood. Now, Rashmi is asking from teacher, ma'am, what are havelis? Teacher is answering, haveli is very big single story house. These houses are made of stone, wood and mud bricks. Most of them have rooms built around a cement courtyard called the Angan, place for children to play and for elder to sit and chat. They have high ceiling and thick wall to keep the house cool even in summer. People living in havelis do not need air conditioner in summer. Now the time have changed. People live in villages have also started making pakka houses just as in cities. Now Ruchika is questioning from the teacher. She is asking something. Ma'am, pakka houses means permanent houses. These are made of bricks, cement, tiles, marble, iron and glass. Teacher is answering, yes, you are right, Ruchika, but pakka houses are not easy to build because raw materials is not easily available. It is costlier also. Now, Rashmi is asking something. Ma'am, one day my father took me to construction site. There he showed me and explained me how pakka houses is constructed. The walls of a pakka house are made of bricks and then plastered with mixture of cement and sand. The roots are made of concrete, asbestos or corrugated iron sheets. The flooring is made up of marble or stones. Pakka houses are more durable and stronger than kaccha houses. They do not need repair frequently. They are built with the all modern facilities and a proper drainage system. These houses are more expensive. Now find out how many people are involved during the construction of a house. What kind of work does each one do? Now teacher, nowadays you must have noticed that there is a shortage of land in cities. This has resulted in the construction of very tall buildings. These are called multi-storied building or skyscrapers. Now Ruchika is asking something. My friend lives in a multi-storied building. It has many floors and each floor has a number of houses. She lives on the 18th floor. Now teacher is answering, yes, a multi-storied building. Each house is called a flat or an apartment. Sorry for the interruption, dear students. Now Rashmi is telling something to the teacher. Ma'am, my cousin has a big house that has many rooms alone and a garage in it. Teacher is answering, very big and spacious houses are called bungalows. Near your colonies, you might have seen people living in small houses made of bamboo, stones and mud. Some people live in makeshift houses and made of iron tin sheets. These are called slums. People use cheap material like plastic, plywood and cardboard to make their houses. There are no proper facilities of drinking water, sanitation, etc. in slums. Now Ruchika is questioning from the teacher, why do people live in slums? Teacher is answering, everybody in cities is not rich. Many poor people are there. It is a very sad situation that people are forced to live in such bad conditions. See this picture. This is multi-storied building picture. These all are multi-storied buildings. This is bungalow, very big house. And this is picture of slum area. Now Ruchika is questioning, what is our government doing for them? Teacher explaining the question, slums are growing day by day, but our government is trying its best to improve the condition of the slum dwellers. It is providing low cost houses to them, as every person has a right to a decent living. Learn these terms, students, like haveli, a very big single storied house. Slums, small houses made of bamboo, stones and mud in big cities. Remember all these things, like houses have changed over time. Houses in which we live are different from the houses in which our grandparents lived. Materials used to build houses have also changed with time. Material used to make houses in villages is different from the materials used in towns and cities. Now, exercise time. Tick the correct option. A very big single-storied house is called, that is Haveli. Haveli is a very big single-story house. Next, poor people live in slums. Next, people live in slums because of poverty. Next, true or false, houses protect us from heat, cold, rain and wild animals. This is true. Next, a haveli is not a big single story house. This is false. Next, a very big and spacious house are called bungalow. Yes, this is right. Houses have not changed over time. This is false. Okay, students, that's all your today's class. Do this exercise on your workbook, exercise A and exercise B, page number 55 of your workbook, and also read this chapter yourself also. Thank you, students. Have a nice day. Goodbye.